Hello, and welcome to Live in the Hearse. This is our second episode, and my guest will be Alan Sanborn. He is a friend I've known for many years.
I'm going to Tourette syndrome, it's all going to be all right.
That's right, yeah. Hello, Alan.
Hey, Karen.
Welcome to Live in the Hearse.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me here. This is fantastic.
You're welcome. Thank you. I know you have a very long history with the month of October, and specifically Halloween. Tell us how you got started.
All right. Well, this, I think I could fairly say, will be my 50th Halloween as a haunter.
Wow.
Yeah, I know. So that makes it kind of fun, kind of exciting. So that started when I was 10. And my grandmother, here I got some photos. You asked me to bring along some photos here. I'll show you. My grandmother at the time lived in a little duplex in Westwood. And that's a picture of her. That's with my sister. And then the little baby is one of her babysitting kids that she had.
Oh, that's great.
Anyway, and so this porch behind there was the front porch where all the trick-or-treaters would come there. So when I was about 10, she was almost like a second mom to me, really. She helped bring us up because my mom would be off working all day and everything. So she was like the neighborhood witch. She used to dress up as a witch for Halloween and she made her own cauldron and everything and pass out all the treats to the kids. And so when I was a little kid, I remember our family, we made like spooky sound effects and stuff for her, to be playing on her porch and stuff like that. But when I was 10, she had a meeting of her like elderly church group friends or whatever it was. And I guess every month they'd meet at somebody's house. And so in October that year, her turn fell in October. So she wanted to have like a Halloween party. So
wow.
I asked my sister and I if we would help her. So making some props and helping with her guests and stuff. And she said if we did that, that we could then have our own party for our friends.
So wow.
We made a bunch of props that year, made a bunch of cardboard tombstones with funny inscriptions, a lot of them from Ripley's Believe It or Not, that sort of thing. She always had like a big ghost on her, a big pumpkin ghost here. I'll show you, this is a picture of her, black and white unfortunately, but on her porch at Halloween with actual trick-or-treaters.
Oh, great.
The pumpkin head ghost.
Oh, wow, that's so wonderful.
Used to wail out all the spooky sounds. So there was that. Oh, and we made a hangman, Harold Herman Howard III. And so that first year, not only did I do a party for my friends then, but also I helped set up her porch with all the new props, or her front yard with all the props. So I sort of consider that my introduction to home haunting. So, for 4 years, I helped her, and then I would go out trick-or-treating and everything. And then that started in 71. In spring of 75, she passed away. Yeah. So I was 14 then. And so I think I just kind of thought, maybe it felt about the right time anyway to stop trick-or-treating. And I just decided to take over haunting at my house, which had always been kind of an afterthought. My mom would pass out treats, but maybe we put up a few cardboard decorations in the window, but that was about it. So I took over the haunting there, which started a 38 year run.
Wow, what a fantastic legacy. Wow.
Halloween at the Sanborn House on Midvale.
That's great.
It started easy. We do little things in the front yard and come up with, cute little effects. And also all this time, every year I kept the tradition up of doing a Halloween party for my friends. And so we'd make props for that that would end up being utilized on Halloween too. And so that went on for a while. And at some point, at some point it became obvious that what we were doing for the trick-or-treaters on Halloween night was probably more important or more fun. We're having a better time with that than we were with the parties for the friends. So that kind of became the key focus, and eventually the parties kind of faded out. But we did. We started in the patio, then we kind of went into backyard adventures where we'd, come up with a little storyline and take them on a whole little adventure through the backyard. And I think you and I met, 89 maybe?
Yes, about 88, I think.
Yeah, okay, so 31, 32 years, something like that, we've known each other.
Wow.
It's been a while.
Pretty incredible.
And you, we had a mutual friend at the time, Josh Berman. And,
okay, we're having a sound issue here. We're having a sound issue.
I wanted to mention that I stepped in for Josh Berman to do some of the camera work and video work because Josh was becoming too busy. And I'm actually very grateful for this because I made lots of new friends and it was great fun.
She took her old witch costume and everything and started wearing that on Halloween night. And we set up initially some of my grandmother's old props. So this was me and my mom and that old pumpkin headed ghost. This is in front of our house now.
That's
great. Our front patio. Wow. Yeah. That's my mom, Janet. So she was for 38 years of haunting at the house. And eventually that would turn musical, but that did take about 15 years or so. I've got a bunch of, so it's some, did you want to talk about the hearse yet? Because they kind of intermingle the stories, so.
Oh, yeah, that's fine. Yeah, please tell us about yours.
In 1985, I had wrecked my Camaro that I had at the time. Anyway, I needed a new car, and my friend Stan saw something. No, I guess I saw it in one of those auto mags or whatever, an ad for a 62 Cadillac Fleetwood hearse for sale for $700. And I thought, that's...
Wow, $700.
That's too weird, isn't it, driving a hearse? And I was like, I should go look at it, though. So I got my friend Stan to go with me, and we checked it out. And I remember afterwards saying, yeah, what do you think? Is it too weird? He goes, no, I think absolutely you have to buy the hearse. I said,
oh,
yeah.
Cool.
So initially, it looked like this. It was gold with a white top.
Oh, wow. I never liked that. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, that's how it looked when we first got it. I wanted to use it primarily, well, of course it was going to be my car, but I also really wanted to use it for Halloween. So, and wanted to make a Halloween statement. So of course I painted it black, which, here I have a photo here of my, this is my friend Anthony dressed up as the Grim Reaper in front of it when it's out in front of our house. That's across the street behind there, but yeah, parked, that's right.
Hey.
So that's what I ended up looking like after the paint job.
Where did you take it to get painted?
I think it was Earl Scheib. I think I went to Earl Scheib's paint job, which was, of course, back in the day, there were commercials all the time for Earl Scheib on TV and everything. So I think that's actually where I went. And you can't tell in this photo, especially in this printed out version of it, but. The license plate for the hearse was OCT31PM, or Halloween night, basically.
That's great. I love that.
That is my email to this day, OCT31PM at AOL.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Very fun.
That's where that comes from. Anybody who knows me probably knows that.
I have a quick question. Do you think your grandmother and your mom are looking down every Halloween to see what you're going to be doing?
I hope so. I think so.
Good answer.
I want to think there's an afterlife, so I hope that they're I hope that they are still enjoying it all. okay, here's a picture inside.
I like to think that they are.
Thank you. I appreciate that. This is a picture inside the hearse, and this was from an early Eve of the Black Month, which is something that you are well acquainted with. So some of my friends.
There. Oh yes, indeed! Wow, very cool.
Yeah, this is something. So the year I got the hearse, and actually the hearse was really the inspiration for it. We started doing a tradition. Bill and I, my friend Bill Goodwin, and I came up with it that we would go around on the evening of September 30th. I had a bunch of black robes that had been my friend Laura Meisner had sewn for various. Mm. Halloween shows and parties we'd done, and so we would go around and the first year we went around, I think after that everybody just showed up at the house, but or we'd go around and pick up everybody in the hearse just without saying a word. I think the first year, nobody knew what we were doing. We just walked up, handed them a black robe, handed them a plastic pumpkin with a lit candle inside, and brought them all along with us in the back of the hearse. And then we had a little welcoming October ceremony in the back of Bill's yard, which we call the Eve of the Black Month. And we have continued to do that every year since. So that's been, what, 35 years now? This year,
fantastic.
For the first time this year, we went virtual, very much like what we're doing right now. And you were there.
Yes, it was a lot of fun, actually.
I wonder how many Eves you've attended over the years. Quite a few.
Quite a few. I would say at least maybe 15.
That sounds about right to me. I thought I had a picture of you at the Eve. I guess not. Here's a picture, by the way, of you from an old party we did back in 89. That's how I knew. I think you're a vampire or somebody. You were some vampire.
Hello, it's time for horror film facts. What do you think, Alfred? Do you want to hear some? Oh, he's really excited. Oh my goodness. Okay. We're going to have to be quiet though. We want everybody to hear. In the movie Nosferatu, Count Orlok is on screen for 9 minutes. And in those 9 minutes, he blinks once. It's towards the end of part one. So next time you watch Nosferatu from 1922, you may want to look for that blink. Let's see what else I have in my goodie bag. Well, many of you have seen The Exorcist with the young Linda Blair. She was only 15 and quite a performer. But more surprising is this is the first horror film to win 10 Oscar nominations from an organization who usually does not recognize horror. Okay, we're going to go towards the bathroom for this one. All joking aside, in the 1950s, many things were not shown on television or in films. However, Psycho was the first American film to show a toilet and to have you hear a toilet flushing. And it scared the crap out of a lot of people. Well, I hope you're getting your Halloween fun on and have something fun planned. Keep the rubber side down and the shiny side up and keep on hearsing. Bye for now.